Hi there and welcome to QualiCorp. It's Nevin Emanuel and today I'm gonna teach you how to flash a BIOS in MSI S61M P31. There are so four variants of this motherboard, so let's go first to the PC. First, and I will show you the steps as well. First thing first, you need to open your PC cover and check for the model. Which model do you have? This doesn't focus. Okay. Once you got there and you see this, then this is the real time, so I'm showing you. And go to the BIOS page by googling it first, as I did here. Then find your motherboard model, which is this H61MP31, and then once you found it, then go here. This is the step 3, and go here. Then normally you can use system information where it can tell you that your BIOS version. Okay. So, SM BIOS version 2.7, seriously, is this upgraded or what? I don't know. It is not telling. It may be upgraded. Okay, if you don't find that it is upgraded or not, because this doesn't tell if it is upgraded or not. Okay, so this doesn't tell. So you need a tool called HW Info, which is hardware info. So I already installed it here. Let's open up and check, go to the motherboard, and it will tell you if the BIOS is upgraded. I hope you are seeing it clearly. Okay. So the BIOS version is here, 2.3, and we have BIOS version here. Update is available. Okay, let's reboot into the BIOS. Okay. Okay, let's actually reboot into the BIOS. My phone doesn't focusing. It is trying to focus because it is Samsung Galaxy Note 5. So the reasons, this is the old phone, that's why it is out of focusing. Okay, you can press F2 or dial. Oh, this is the oldest BIOS. Seems like it. And this is the Intel looking BIOS, as you can see. Okay, here is the BIOS version. Oh my god. Here is, as you can see, here is M-Flash. So, okay, so we can use this in order to flash the BIOS. Good, this BIOS looks like Intel, but in a way of gaming BIOS, very Windows 3.1 looking BIOS or Turbo C type BIOS. Anyways, let's go. Now, fourth step, make sure you have prepared your USB. Okay. Next, prepare a USB for that. For God's sake. Okay. So next, prepare the USB. Not this one, but this one. Okay. basically we need a fat thirty two USB, I guess, because maybe this BIOS is too old for this. So let's format into FAT32 and okay. If it is in NTFS, simple, you can. Okay, I am cancelling it, and let me show you. Okay, how to format a USB, anyways, for the BIOS, of course, for the sake of BIOS. Okay, go to format and NTFS to FAT32. Just rename as BIOS start. Yes, okay, done. Close this. If you don't see this, okay, I will teach you how to format the USBs anyways. Okay, once you have downloaded your BIOS, it should be in the download folder with the name. As you can see, here is the name of the file. Okay, you can check this by going here. Yeah, that you have downloaded it from here. Okay, so next, so you can open it from there. Okay, next, extract this to folder. Oh, sorry, I was okay. Just copy these two files, three files. You can't see it. Just copy. I have a long list, man. Press Ctrl C. Then go to the USB called BIOS. Wait. Then go to your USB called BIOS, which you formatted, and paste it here. Done. Then unplug your BIOS USB. Yes, you need your own PC to do that, but I have two PCs, so I can do it. After that, make sure when you're flashing the BIOS, put the USB at the back of your motherboard, so it will stay connected. If you have graphics card or anything or any peripherals, you should remove them. Okay, let's plug this USB in at the back of this computer. I have to teach everybody very noob things. Okay, once you have done, Control Alt Delete. Press F2. Yes, this BIOS is old, so that's why it is using press F2 thing. Go to nflash, select one file. Okay, here it is. As you can see, if you can't see, select one file to update BIOS. Double click that, go to your USB, and make sure it is matching with the same number, E7788. Okay, it must be matched with this E788IMS. Let's see if it is matching or not. Hoping. As you can see, it is matching. And yes, make sure this is the older version and you are upgrading to a newer version. Yes, my hand is shaking right now. Okay, I'm impressed that BIOS supports the mouse. Wow. Okay, next begin. Do not turn off your system during this or unplug anything. it will be done very, very quickly, and it will restart. Do not unplug any USB or turn off the power of the PC. During this time, let it flash, okay? As you can see, it is flashing. Okay, it's done. It should be restarting. The display must be come up. Okay, so display is here. Let's go back to the BIOS again. Maybe it will restart 1 to 2 times in order to do it. So because it is resetting all settings, then it will be configuring everything. And then, okay, now you can unplug the USB because your BIOS is successfully flashed. Control, Alter, and Delete. I did this to put a graphics card in it that even I feel really crazy about this. Oh, it is going to Windows. Anyways, wait. Let it start in Windows. So we will confirm that we have successfully done the upgrade of the BIOS. We will show in the hardware monitor which I installed in this particular computer. My hand was still shaking because I really scared of flashing BIOSes in the computer. Anyways, but I did it because I know the drill. So this is Mr. Solution, Mr. Hager's shop PC. Okay. Finally. That's done. Okay, we are back again. As you can see, we have flashed the BIOS in the is this computer successfully. It is open now. This doesn't tell anything because some computer does like to hide the BIOS versions. So you can check too one more thing, but DHDAC doesn't also don't tell. Okay. Finally we have done this. We have liftoff. As you can see, here you go. Okay, so as you can see, the BIOS is upgraded to very latest as here. 2.7 version. Okay? And it's still the oldest BIOS. Let's go back to restart and show you the actual BIOS. Okay. Let's restart. Oh, my hands are still shaking, man. Okay. I think the keys are changed. It was F2, now it is Dell. Okay, let me tell you one thing. In the old BIOS, we should use F2, but in this new BIOS, which is upgraded, now you can use Dell button or delete button, so you can go into a BIOS. As you can see, here it is. It is the latest BIOS now in this computer. So that's how you can flash your BIOSes, but be careful, do not flash other computer BIOSes in other computers because it will destroy the motherboard. And yes, everything you will be doing at your own risk and responsibility. Napnim Angel or my channel don't take responsibility if anything happens to your computer, because I always make videos for educational purposes only. And yes, if you follow my steps correctly, you can save your life as well. Okay, so that's how you can do it. So that is all for today, and thank you for watching, and have a nice day, and peace out.